In this video, I'm going to give you a quick mnemonic way to remember the cosine and sine values of the major angles in the first quadrant of the unit circle. So the context is, imagine you're taking a paper test and you realize you need cosine of pi over 6 and you blank on what that is. Okay, so let's take these major angles and I'm going to write 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Next, let's take each of those numbers I just wrote, compute its square root and divide it by 2. So we'll do square root of 4 divided by 2. Square root of 3 divided by 2, square root of 2 divided by 2, square root of 1 divided by 2, square root of 0 divided by 2. Okay, so square root of 4 and square root of 0 are sort of silly, so is square root of 1. But what each of these gives us is the cosine value on the circle. So the cosine value when theta is 0 is square root of 4 over 2, that's 1, as expected, because we're 1 unit along the x-axis. For pi over 6, so that's the smallest positive angle here, take pi and divide it by 6. Our cosine value is square root of 3 over 2. At pi over 4, it's square root of 2 over 2. At pi over 3, it's square root of 1 over 2, but square root of 1 is just 1. So let's call that 1 half. And then cosine of pi over 2 is like 0, because we are 0 units left or right on the x-axis. For the sine values, let's just reverse them. So 1. And then square root of 3 over 2. This is square root of 2 over 2. Sorry, hope you can read that. This is 1 half. And this is 0. Okay, so if you can remember 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, square root divided by 2, you get your cosine values first, then reverse them for your sine values. Keep in mind, if you're trying to remember even which angle is which, pi over 6 is smaller than pi over 4 is smaller than pi over 3, because when we cut pi by 6, we're getting a smaller slice. So this is pi over 6, pi over 4, pi over 3.